cannot name a scientist from here. Yeah. You cannot name anybody other than core, hardcore religious philosophers.
Yeah.
Like them or not, they are the only people who did do whatever it took to create the influence. Now, you can argue, one can argue that people were looking for it. People are too emotional and religious people here. Yeah. Well, that's irrelevant. What's relevant is that whoever was trying to take the initiative of coming into a better self of influence and then leadership and then practice whatever he thought was right. Yeah. Doesn't matter what you believe or not. But he did practice whatever he believed in. Now, let's just assume that I don't believe, or Pakistani doesn't believe in the madrasa, but then he's not doing anything about it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We see Asma Jahangiris and we see Nawaz Sharifs and Imran Khans, but they have a far less influence than Ashraf Ali Thanvi, Ahmad Reza Bareilvi, Dr. Israr, or Ghamdi. You know what I'm saying? These people have a way bigger canvas of influence. So that means thought leadership is somehow taught in the madrasa.
Yeah.
And if practice or not, or the way it's practiced is something which you weave to or not, is of a different discussion. The real discussion is, they have not really penetrated the class where you actually define something which is appealing to you.
Yeah.
So they couldn't really create the appeal. And that's where basic serotonin hierarchy comes into play. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, that's how it is. That's how I'm sorry.
Serotonin is in the canvas again.
Yeah, because, you know, if these same people with the same venom, vigor, I'm sorry. Same vigor. Because their vigor is treated as venom. And if they were actually leftists, with the same courage attributes, personal attributes of Ashraf Ali Thanvi, if he was a leftist, he would have been a global leader.
Yeah.
Which he, by the way, is.
Kind of.
It's a big, big power of influence. He's got a big, bigger canvas. And by the way, he's one of my favorite people from this region. Okay. I rate him even more than Shah Waliullah.
Oh my God.
I do. In terms of his, the way he was, where he was, the way he was placed, the kind of forces he was against, Shah Waliullah had a lot more equity.
And he had
a lot more. Of course, no credit taking away from, because, you know, if you ask Ashraf Ali Thanvi, he's going to be slapping me. Yeah. What the hell are you talking about? I'm not even a dot in the ocean compared to him. But I'm talking about for our region.
Yeah,
I think the kind of dust Ashraf Ali Thanvi was cleaning, Shah Waliullah had a lot. It was way easier. People really knew from black and white.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So this kind of thought leadership was way more influential. And then you can see in the current times, you can see how Maulana Ishaq was facing a lot of arrows.
Yeah.
He still is. You know, people saw about Maulana Ishaq.
We've got the typical Maulvis.
The right hates Maulana
Ishaq. They hate.
Despicable. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But I think...
Similar with Dr. Israr as well, he was alienated in the last year.
He should have been alienated. You know why? Because he was actually threatening the core of the left philosophy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Israr was not threatening. If anything, he was way more towards the left than but, you know, when you look at the Maulvi, and nobody hates Maulana Ishaq from the left, and everybody hates that same Maulvi from the right.
Right.
So you have to see, you know, where how the hell is this diagram coming to play? And if you're not looking at it intellectually, then you don't have a say in whether you hate somebody or not. If you have that kind of intellect or an acumen to actually understand of where thought leadership actually sets itself in terms of influence and morality, and where the hell these people want or are taking the whole flock, then you can see it. You know, I can see that, I can read the map, and I can pinpoint of whether I want to be in that train or that train, because it's leading to that station. But people don't really know where any movie is taking them, except the masjid.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Except the 3-4 commandments that every masjid has, that, you know, you got to do this.